Daniel Jacobs can knock you out in the ring, but he's also a great, great broadcaster. Tell me about what you saw tonight here at the StubHub Center in Carson.
I've seen a tremendous night. I've seen a great night of boxing. You had a young up-and-coming champion in Keith Thurman one time. He made a outstanding performance. Figueroa had a great performance, although it was a little bit lackluster for the crowd. And everyone just gave a great performance tonight.
Matisse Molina, fight of the year so far.
How could I forget that?
Twice.
That was just an amazing fight. You know, you have to give Molina credit. I don't think this is anything bad for his career. I think this kind of catapults him in a way because no one can lose a fight like this. You know what I mean? The fans want to see both of these guys back in the ring. So I'm excited to see what the future has in store for those guys.
Speaking of the future, what's next for Daniel Jacobs?
Peter Quinlan.
You serious?
Peter Quinlan. I mean, I want him.
That'll
be huge. Let's get him. I mean, this fight needs to happen. He's calling out all these other guys that's on different networks. And obviously, we already know the war that's going on with that situation. So it only makes sense for this fight to happen.
Peter Quinlan needs to agree.
At the Barclays Center, July 26th. I got it all figured out.
It will sell out like crazy. Peter's popular. You're popular. It's your hometown.
And it's a picture perfect for both of us. I mean, obviously, with everything going on right now, us fighting each other at the Barclays, we're both Brooklyn guys, so it makes picture perfect sense for me.
I saw you licking your chops last weekend.
I was.
I know. I saw that.
I wanted some of that Hershey.
Richard, we saw fight of the year tonight. Molina, Matisse, what did you think of what you saw?
Well, first of all these so-called experts who say it was a mismatch, you know, they've got
a lot of egg on
their face, you know. A great fight. Both guys came to fight. It's just a fantastic night. A great night for boxing.
Yeah, it is.
Great fight.
And I had a wonderful time commentating, so it was just a great weekend for myself and the whole staff and the fans of boxing in general.
But now we need you back in the ring.
I'll be there.
I'll see you. Are you going to be in Vegas?
I will be.
Okay, great. I'll see you in Vegas.
Okay, Dan.
Right. Before I let you go, Dan, real quick, Mayweather and Maidana, what's your take on that fight?
You know what? I'm not really big at giving my opinion on fights or who be the winner, but I'm going to go with Mayweather, and I'm going to tell you why. I'm going to go with Mayweather because not only has he always performed at an elite level, every fight, every time he comes in there, he gives his best. And his best is the best, right? So you have to give him credit where credit is due. But Maidana is one of those guys where you can't take your eyes off him. I mean, he quote-unquote figured the blueprint out, right? So let's see if he can do the same thing come May 3rd.
My last question. We're here in Los Angeles. Tomorrow, maybe tonight, you're going to the airport. Who do people confuse Daniel Jacobs the most when he's at the airport? Who do you get the most?
Probably Will Smith.
No, they think you're Will Smith?
Probably R. Kelly or Usher.
Okay, who does he look like the most of those three? Will Smith, Usher, R. Kelly. Who does he look like? R. Kelly?
Hold on a second. Hopefully after I get this championship, they'll recognize me as who I am, which is Daniel Jacobs.
I could see the Will Smith one the most. So there you have Daniel Jacobs. Right. You can follow him on Twitter and Instagram at
Daniel Jacobs TKO.
There you have it. FiercelyReporting.com. I'm Ali Stickback reporting.